All right, guys, let's talk about some of my most fidgety knives in the collection. Now, I will say, before we get into the collection, I don't necessarily deem, like, fidget factor. Some people, you know, every knife tuber is different, but some people, like, definitely consider fidget factor as one of their considerations when they choose a knife for EDC, and at least if it is fidgety, so to speak. So for me, I really don't love fidget factor, but I thought it might be fun to talk about some knives that are super fidgety, and when I do carry these, I do notice myself playing with them more often than my lesser fidgety EDC knives. However, that being said, like I said, this isn't like a deem of quality, a vote of confidence. It doesn't necessarily, just because a knife's fidgety doesn't make it a good knife. It just means that the action is easy to use, the knife is easy to deploy and or put away. So first one up on the list, and the one I've already been playing with, is the Demco Knives 8020.5. Now, I actually have a couple of these. This is my sheep's foot, or as they call it, shark's foot version, but it's basically a sheep's footed blade. This one's probably my more favorite of the two, and of course it is growing, or this one helps grow my collection of orange knives in EDC. So of course, have to talk about those few things, but the shark lock is really what makes this thing so fidgety. Not only does the shark lock give you multiple ways to open your knife, and I guess I should say there's multiple ways to open this knife in general, whether it's the thumb stud, the opener, or the lock itself, but it is super easy to flick open, flick closed. It is one of those knives that is super, super fidget friendly because of that shark lock. Now, I will say on most shark locks, they are pretty grippy, so do expect your finger, whichever finger you're using, to get a little bit ripped up if you fidget with it too much, but that doesn't mean that it's not super fidgety. All right. Next one up is going to be the Spyderco Smock. Now, the Smock for me is one that it is, like I said, like one of those knives that when I do EDC this thing, I find myself pulling it out and playing with it more often than not. And that's because it has a really, really good action. And this thing just returns to home every single time. You flip it out and it just wants to go back home. And that is partly in due to the fact that it is on caged ball bearings, but also too, it has this kind of reverse compression lock in here. So you guys can see this little piece of metal right here. That is actually this guy right here. So the button. So this guy is kind of deceptive. Some people might think this is like a button lock knife, and it kind of technically is, because you do use a button to depress it, but that button actually, instead of just being a direct, you know, pin that goes in place and locks the knife down, it actually is, that pin is connected to, or that button I should say, is connected to the lock bar. So it's once again very much a compression lock that just has this kind of easy access bar to keep everything very flush, very fit, and of course that goes with the styling of the Smock as a whole. In addition to, I will say probably the least fidgety part about this is its flipper tab. And that is because for me, there is no texturing on it. And because it is kind of, it is a rounded over, but because it is a 90 degree angle, basically, if you don't hit it just right, it can kind of hurt you a little bit. So usually what I do with this knife to make it a little bit more comfortable is I kind of go for the mid portion of my index finger and just light switch it. Because usually when I do that, it's fairly comfortable, fairly good to use, and it's pretty easy. In addition to, if I don't do that, I'll sometimes come up with my thumb and just, once again, flick it with my thumb. I find if you use any meatier parts of your finger, it's usually a little bit more comfortable than just the straight up tip or pad of your index finger. So anyways, super fidgety action, and really find myself playing with it a surprising amount. Now, another one that is also a flipper is my XM 18 3.5 inch by Rick Hinderer knives. This one, very similarly to the Smock, is also on caged ball bearings, but this one's on aftermarket Smock, or sorry, not Smock, Skiff ball bearings. So you guys can see this thing is an absolute guillotine, where you get it going and it literally just drops shut on its own. This thing has a wicked, wicked smooth action, and it is tuned to literal perfection. So this thing is hard to not fidget with. This is one that my friends just love, and I love, partly because once again it's super purple, but also too, that action is just unbelievably smooth. So that is the next one up. All right. Now going into automatics or illegal knives. For some of you guys, they are legal for me to carry, but the next one up is going to be the Phoenix, and this is by Asheville Steel or Paragon, whatever you'd like to call them. This is the Generation 1 Phoenix, and this one, as you guys can see, is a gravity knife, so it is naturally very fidgety because it has a lot of similar characteristics to the Balisong, and so that means you have to use gravity to actuate it. So if you want to have the blade come out, you have to use some wrist motion in there to flick it out. Now, you don't usually have to use too much in order to get it out. You usually have to use a little bit more, but especially to close it, just a little snap of the wrist and you'll get it to close. So anyways, as you guys can see here, that I'm already fidgeting with it quite a bit. It is super fun because it just has this nice loose action that's very flowy. And yeah, so it's very fidgetable. All right, next ones up are going to be automatics. So this one is going to be my button lock and kind of just push button switchblade, so to speak. This is my Protec Strider SMG. Now I do have another auto, the Benchmade Auto Adamus, but I feel like this one is a little bit more fidgety in my opinion, partially because of one reason, and that is that the spring that drives this action is not as hard as the Adamus. So not only is it less snappy, but still fun, but it's also just super easy to close one-handed. Like you guys can see here, this is not a challenge at all for me. Like you do have to maintain constant pressure, but very easy to open and close one-handed. So I really love that about this. And once again, because of that ease of one-handed operation, I end up playing with this thing a lot. Okay, last one up is going to be OTFs as a whole. This one in particular is my Heretic Knives Manticore X, and of course this one's the Bounty Hunter version, but because it is an OTF, it is super, super fidgetable because you can just push that, you know, slide and it will open and or close, and it is just a very satisfying knife. Love this thing, love to look at it, love to open it, love to deploy it, close it, all that fun stuff. It's just a fun knife in general. So that is why it ends up being a little bit more fidgety, but once again, this kind of goes for all of my OTFs, like my smaller Ultratech by Microtech. So pretty cool, pretty fidgety blades overall, but yeah. Anyways, guys, that has been a look at my most fidgety knives in the knife collection. Hopefully you've enjoyed the list. Hopefully it's been fun. As always, God bless, and I'm out.